Welcome to this video series about improvising by Sietse de Vries. You can support this video series by donating the amount of your choice to Sietse de Vries' Patreon account, which can be found by searching Sietse de Vries Patreon or by finding the link in the description below the video. Enjoy the video.
In an earlier video, I talked about the fast food of music being sequences. Everyone likes them and they really can be a very nice, elegant way of just passing time, basically. And I was explaining in that video that it's all about fifths going down or going up, and that you use the same kind of 5-1 cadence all the time. So something like this. And you probably noticed, as long as I just stay with the black, with the white keys, and I don't use any black keys, I will just stay in C major. And it makes complete sense, because that's what a sequence does. If you just stay with the notes of the key you're in, you don't go anywhere. You just have a beautiful way of passing time. But of course, there is actually a very important function for sequences as well, and that is when you want to go to a different key. And the only thing you have to do is play the same sequences, but now you sneak in a sharp or a flat, or you leave actually one out, depending on what key you are in and what key you want to go to. So if I start in C major again and I add an F sharp, which is of course the first accidental you will encounter when you want to go in that direction of the circle of fifths, you can actually end up in G major. Of course, you don't do it right in the beginning. That sounds silly. Then you have something like this. That doesn't work. So first you start in C major, and after a few bars you decide somewhere in one of the voices, playing instead of the normal F natural, you play a F sharp. And of course, then you stick with the F sharp, and then you end up in a very elegant way in G major. And of course, keep in mind, we talked about it before, it's nice if you have a certain amount of bars. So 4 bars or 8 bars, that's nice. Then you have a complete sentence and then it makes sense. As a listener, you think, yes, we really completed this line. I can do the same trick with going from C major to F major. And of course, now I need B flat instead of a B natural. The same trick, you don't do it right in the beginning, but somewhere halfway you sneak in the B flat and you stick with it. This is of course very useful to know, because if you consider how a lot of concertos, for example, are constructed, Handel was a master at it. He just had a nice theme that could be anything, just something that's easy to remember. You play it in the main key, you have sequences, maybe you do it again in the same key, then you have sequences going to a different key, can be the dominant key, subdominant, or a relative key, and you play the theme again. Sequences again, once more the main theme, maybe now again in another key, or in the end, of course, you want to go back to the main key. And you actually don't need anything else than having a good theme and sequences. And it's just a nice, entertaining music that you can make. It's not always really deep, but it's beautiful music and it's good to know, because this is the material that you need when you improvise. You can actually see a sequence also as a kind of escape when you're kind of stuck in your brain, you don't know what to do next. Well, start a beautiful series of sequences, and in the meantime, your brain is free to think of something else. And if you do it correctly and in a nice way, that it's tasteful, then sequences are really, really useful. So let's see if I can make a little concerto. I will just use a very simple theme. One of the tricks to find a simple theme is just use broken triads, for example. So if my main theme is something like this, that's basically a broken triad and a cadence 4-5-1. And I can repeat that in the dominant key. And then without any warning, I can go back to the main key, start some sequences, and then maybe use the theme a few more times in different keys. And in the end, you have kind of a concerto. So let's see if it works. Of course, it's really useful to know sequences in different ways. So one I used a few times now was the typical Italian thing that Vivaldi would do with a string orchestra, and that's it, that you repeat chords an octave down and you have a kind of effect like this. And of course, if you can elaborate that with some fast scaling up and down, some ornaments, which is basically just smokescreen. I mean, that's a technical thing that you can play those little ornaments. But the basic idea is actually very simple. So one of the tasks you can really get some interesting results is if you practice sequences in as many ways as you can in different keys. We talked about it before, you can have a little motif that you repeat in the left, that you have alternating rhythms, but also that you actually involve some nice dissonant sounds, that you have suspensions, for example, so that you do things like, instead of going right from 1 to 4, you can also linger on the E here, so that you have a nice dissonant sound. Which is basically a kind of suspension that you make, and if you stick with the pattern, you can just repeat it every time. And it goes for a lot of interesting things that you can do with sequences. You can change the rhythm, you can involve some parts in the middle, some voices to make things interesting. For example, in a dotted rhythm, so in a kind of overture, you get something like this. And all the tricks we talked about before, like parallel thirds, they're really nice to use in a sequence as well. So the basic idea is still doing this. But now it can sound like this. And the more easy you get with all these different types of sequences going from one version to the other in different keys, the more agile you are to go to different keys and to make things interesting. So, although it's fast food of music, it's a very interesting thing to know, and it's really something you should practice so that you can have interesting bridges between themes and interesting ways to go from one key to another.